Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play The Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind, as brought to you by my amazing supporters over on Patreon, where we last left off. I had come back to town, and we had sold a bunch of stuff because I was overburdened with a ton of Daedric crap, and, you know, that tends to be the way of things. We're noticing now that since we're getting better heavy armor, our carrying capacity is not quite, you know, working out for us as well as I would like, but we do what we can. Ideally, in the long term, what I'll end up doing probably is enchanting some gear with feather, because I believe it stacks, and I'll just wear, like, you know, my clothing, like my pants and shirt, I'll just make those with feather as much as I can, and that's kind of what we'll run around to offset the fact that our heavy armor is so heavy. And realistically, I don't expect to be running around in full Daedric armor at all during this entire playthrough. Simply, well, for two reasons. Primarily, actually, because it's so damn heavy. And why am I down here? I actually want to take another trip with her. Primarily because it's so heavy. A full suit of Daedric armor, even at 100 strength, is like 3/4 of your carrying capacity. And that is, you know, a bit more than I'm necessarily willing to invest. Alright, so Nisus. We are going to Nisus. And then from Nisus, we're gonna go south, and ideally I won't get distracted by, you know, large structures filled with Daedra and all kinds of incredibly nice gear. Oh, that's right, we levitated across the gorge. Alright, I remember. Over we go. You do you, creepy Silt Strider thing. Creepy still here. I love how they basically just like hew a chunk of these things' backs out and use, I think they say it's like nerve endings that is how they control where they move. Which is like, you think about that, that's fucking horrible. Although I suppose realistically bugs don't they don't function like we do, because God, how do I want to explain this? Bugs don't think like people do. Think of bugs kind of like nature's robots. It's weird. Just read up on it sometime. It's actually really fascinating how insects work, because like they are completely alien compared to how, you know, people and animals work. It's really fascinating. I highly recommend reading up on it. Suffice it to say, it sounds horrible that they're, you know, screwing with its exposed nerves, but it probably doesn't realize that they're doing what they're doing, because to it, it's just kind of, you know, obeying what nature has set forth for it, even though it doesn't realize it's really not. Okay, so I'm actually gonna go ahead and drop some fatigue restorative magic on us. I mean, we have a bunch of stamina potions now, I suppose I can start. Oh no, I gotta re-hotkey them. I suppose I can start actually drinking these things again. Let's see, these guys, okay. There. God, that restores our stamina so fast, it's ridiculous. All right, so there's Daedra Place, we're not gonna worry about that. We've cleared it as far as I'm aware. There's probably a teleporter in there. Those things are linked together. And there's like a portal system that you can use to get from one to the next. And you can essentially use them to kind of fast travel around the island, kind of. The only downside is that you've got to obviously fight all of the horribleness inside of them. And we got some Betty Netches up here, which, if I recall correctly, Betty Netches are hostile. They will attack us. So I don't necessarily want to provoke them, just because, you know, we got stuff we need to do, guys. We got a long way south to walk. Well, I guess we'll just go across terrain and kill everything that gets in our way. Sorry, Betty Netches, but that's probably gonna be you. Ah! Where is it? Get out of here. Okay. The walk begins. And I think, unlike the later games, Oblivion, Skyrim, and Fallout, and those, this, your move speed is not impacted by having your weapon out. So we can, if I, you know, really decide to, run around with our sword and shield out all day, every day, and it's not gonna affect anything too much. Okay, so let me check. All right, we're making good progress. That's the thing about this, is the world isn't as big as it seems. because, like, it's weird how to explain it. Like, the world in this isn't small. I'm not saying that. I mean, it's... That's right, you leave me alone. It's not small, but based on, like, the scale of the map and stuff, it looks like it's bigger than it is. I mean, like, we're already halfway there, and I've been walking for probably, like, 2 minutes, maybe three. Oh, and I just saw Cliff Razor. Ah. It's all about the terrain. It's like in Skyrim, where the world's not particularly huge, but it takes forever to get anywhere if you're not using fast travel because there's mountains everywhere. Oh my god, seriously, another one of these things? No! We explored one last time. Speaking of which, I don't remember whether or not I ticked it off in our list of how many places we've explored. I'm not gonna tick it off. I'm gonna assume that I did. If I didn't, like, bitch at me in the comments or something. I will have mentioned it. I'm pretty good about mentioning when I'm ticking one off on the list, so if I didn't mention it, figure I was just being a doof and didn't tick it off, and let me know, and I will increment our counter appropriately. We're sitting at, I think, yeah, 17, which, I mean, it's not bad. And like I said, I'm gonna work with 50 as our goal, which, if I really wanted to, we could probably hammer that out in like a couple weeks episodes, because, oh, what's that? There's a person down there. Oh, and there's a shipwreck over there. Oh, I wonder if there's a refugee. Oh shit, I'm falling. No! Screw you, Cliff Razor. Hey. What do you need now? Oh, this is the dude carving the shrine. All right, so how's the shrine coming? Not done yet. Soon, though. You go away and let me work now. Can't work with people watching. Sometimes I don't even watch Big Rock, you know? All right. So this is where he's making it, and I assume this is the Big Rock that he's carving it out of. That's good to know. I'm surprised he doesn't... Damn it. M to bring up the map every time. Okay, so, upside is that there's town, like, right over here-ish. And if I recall correctly, hey, there's actually a cave right there. All right, sure, we'll do caves. I'll do some cave, oh, now Drews! Now get me out of the water. Everything stuns in the water. You jerks, if I had AoEs. All right, now it's just freaking slaughter fish. Drink a potion. I'm missing all the time because my stamina's just cooked down. Here. Chop our way to victory. Make some sushi. All right, there we go. Out of the water. And it's getting stuck in trees. Nice. Fix that problem. We have Ilunibi, Carcass of the Saint. What is this? Aside from a quick save. All right, let's see what we have here. And we will go with... We'll try out our superior cat's eye spell in here. Yeah, I mean, look at that. That makes it, you know, I wouldn't say daylight in here, but substantially brighter. Okay. Yeah, it's looking like, at least for me, like I said, let me know in the comments if this is not bright enough and I will bump it up. But for me, this is about right, I think. Yeah, I mean, so there's water and that's tempting to explore, but I wanna see what's over here. Okay. This place is creepy. Okay, so it's probably, I was gonna say, probably full of, like, corpus devotees. Like, especially now that we've got naked people here running around. Dreamers, yeah. There's the corpus meat. Alright. I eating somebody in here? A dead adventurer. Adjusting my freaking pop filter. Yeah, I'm actually thinking about getting a new pop filter, one that I can actually attach to the mic itself instead of this, I don't want to say external, but a better one than the one I have, because the one I have is kind of a pain in the ass because I have to constantly fuss with it. So there's a master's lockpicks and a master's probe, which is nice. Chitin armor, some other junk, and a wild spark sword, which judging by the look of it is dwarven. Dweemer, rather. It's worth 350 and it weighs 8. So we'll take that. That, I think, is probably worth it. We're gonna recast our cat's eye. Yeah, I'm definitely liking this. This 30 power one. I think the next level we get, I'm probably gonna, assuming we can, invest some magic into, what is this, illusion? Or invest some skill points into illusion. Oh no, I don't think we can, because I'm fairly certain that we've actually reached our max level from training in it. All right, no, actually I'm wrong. It's governed by personality, that's what was limiting me. Although, we actually are really close to gaining a level in illusion magic just by way of casting it. Oh, where are you? An ash slave, all right. Your death magic will not save you from me. Oh, this is just great. What is this? The tainted marrow. This is just, Let's go into tainted marrow, guys. We will, but I wanna clear this area first. This place is like pretty interesting. I was hoping to like look at the map and see it be shaped like a human or something. It might be, for all I know. Looks like there might be a way over there. That, or it's just a little side, not a passage, but like a nook in the wall. And there's our illusion skill increase. I mean, if nothing else, I guess we're getting skill ups from constantly casting spells to see in the dark. Hey, it's an ash ghoul. Oh, an ash zombie, I'm sorry. Well, he did a thing, just not very effectively. Right, and over here we have Marowak's spine. All right, we're going into a Pokemon spine, guys. I see a bone lord down there. I think there are actually greater versions of these things too, so we should probably actually, oh, hey, Storm Astronaut. Yeah. Here, what I wanna do while it's on my mind is grab my soul trap. Hold still, there we go. Give me your soul. I'm a collector, yours too. Ow. Oh, I'm getting beat on by a couple things here. Let's chug some potions for healing. Kill the Storm Astronaut. Kill the Storm Astronaut, please. There we go. Whoa. Did that thing summon that ghoul? No, the ghoul's... Alright. Ash Zombie, rather, is weird. I don't know how that worked, but okay. Cat's eye going again here. And continue poking around. Okay, well, doesn't seem to be anything really in here, just a little campfire, so I'm not too worried about that. Looks like another door down there. That might take us to Tainted Marrow, if I had to guess. Let's come down this way. My Ash Slave. Hey, our long blade leveled and we gained a level. Nice. Come at me. And since this is a fighty type level, I gotta remember to go back to town before we sleep so that I can level like armor skills so that I can get my endurance. And I do recall, I think a couple people mentioned that I had to, I have to level it 10 times to get the full bonus. Alright, so some Dweemer bracers, which are not better than what we have. More Dweemer boots, which we already have. Some gold, crappy lock picks, and a silver staff of shaming, which is useless to me. Okay. Dead adventurers all over the place. There's no escape from a naked dude with a shitty club. Yeah, no escape for you, maybe. I don't know. All right, so where's this taking us? All right, so that's taking us to Tainted Marrow. Let's see, well, my map now, okay. Just seeing how far the line of sight is, because like, I can see this door. Does it map it for me down this far? No. Blackened Heart. Okay. So that's two more side areas. We have both Tainted Marrow and Blackened Heart. And here we have, by the look of things, nothing. I assume this is probably where that guy that attacked us was just kind of, you know, hanging out. Gonna drink a stamina potion. Recast my... Oh, come on now. There we go. Recast my light. Speaking of which, yeah, we're up to a 96% chance to successfully cast this. Maybe I'll make one that has a better duration next time we hit town, assuming I remember. This is, I believe, Blackened Heart. No, we're in Tainted Marrow. I want to actually go to Blackened Heart. Because we know Tainted Marrow takes us back to the starting area where we came in, so that's going to be what I explore last. I assume it's just kind of a connection type area. So, Blackened Heart first. I assume this is probably the last area in here. Well, I'm going to get you. I'm coming for you. Yeah, knock down. I'm noticing that as our skill goes up, we're knocking things down more reliably, which I can kind of appreciate, because up to this point, it felt kind of one-sided. Like, enemies were always knocking me down, but I was never knocking them down. He's knocking things down. I gotta find that damn cave that had that Nord in it. A Corpus Stalker that had that really tough Nord in it that we found early on and who kicked our ass a couple times. I want to go back and murder him. I also want to go back to that cave that had the two, skeleton champions or skeleton warriors or whatever in it, along with that full suit of orcish armor. Okay, so this just loops around. This game is such good music. It's not always thematic, but it's good. I have a hunger, which these guys can be pretty dangerous, but if I'm lucky, I'll kill him before he does anything too nasty to me. Yeah. And a Dater Heart. Again, I should be soul trapping things, but I'm not. Here, what is it? Four? No. Or is it six? There we go. So where's this taking me? To Souls Rattle. Oh my gosh. This place is just going. Okay, so there's a side area I want to check out. It's interesting, the blue on the map. That's the water, if I had to guess. If I recall correctly, when you make interior cells in at least Morrowind, you can choose whether or not they have water in them. And if they do, it creates essentially like a water plane in the world space that you create. So, you know, everything but below, you know, a certain point on the Z-axis is just underwater. But I mean, whatever. Hey, if it works for you, go for it. I suppose it represents a realistic water table, I guess? I don't know. I don't know. Oh shit. Continue running executable. Texture not found for a weapon, crystal blade glow. Yes. That's interesting. That's the first real hardcore error we've had like that, I think. Normally you get those during the load screen. And this thing has got some regen going. I'm gonna drink a potion so I can actually hit it. Not so much to a lame Corpus. So you drink a potion, not, like I said, not so much so that I can heal, but so that I can have stamina. Oh, a scamp. Man, that's terrifying. Scamps are scary at like first level. Past that, not too much. Well, I should say scams are scary until you get a silver weapon. Even at low levels, they're not particularly dangerous, so long as you're, you know, prepared going into a fight with one of them. Okay, where's my cat's eye? The only downside to this thing is it only lasts a minute, which that time goes quick. All right, so since that sword, that texture was for some sort of crystal sword, I assume there's a cool weapon in here somewhere. The game is spoiling itself for me. It's probably in there. And this is collapsed. Alright. Carefully approach. Creepy altar thing. Not full of Corpus meat. Alright. Well, I'll take the armorer's hammer. Take the potion. Scroll of Elemental Burst Frost, I'm okay with. And just a normal old silver staff that can stay. Now, what happens if I play the Song of Storms? Okay, so we've got some glass boots, which is nice. I'm taking those, they're worth 8,000. iron tanto, looks like some bone mold. And a common amulet and a common ring. And an iron tower shield, alright. There may be also a glass sword floating around here somewhere, and I just can't see it because of that texture error. Which would be kind of disappointing because glass weapons are actually really cool in this. I don't know, like, I really liked glass armor in this. I do not like glass armor in Oblivion, and I actually don't recall what it looks like in Skyrim, so. All right, so that looks like about it. Okay, I gotta know. I'm gonna save before I do this, just in case. I gotta know what's on the other side of this, if there's anything. Okay, nope, just an empty room. Okay, I was just curious. If there were anything in there, I wouldn't take it and we'd actually just leave anyways, because I have no idea how to get in there. But I just wanted to see. I just crushed some hopes and dreams there, probably. I'm sorry if I ruined your immersion by showing off that the, you know, cave entrance on the other side there is in fact just an empty room, but it is what it is. Anyways, we're at 22 minutes, well, 21 minutes and change. So I'm gonna go ahead and call it. So as usual, folks, thank you for watching. And I'll catch you all next time. We're probably gonna exit this place, finish exploring, and I will move on. I'm gonna go ahead and tick this off now, because otherwise I'm gonna forget. So, I will catch you all next time. Until then.